I grew up in a family of eight, one of eight children. Didn't really know what I wanted to do with my future. Around about grade nine, I got an interest in science and thought that was something pretty cool, something pretty interesting that I could apply my brain to, because my dad was a scientist, but went into the IT world and had a successful career there. My mum was a teacher. She always was interested in education and also instilled that value of education into our family. We were living in Geelong at the time. Deakin was a university that was close by and they had an open day. My dad zeroes in on this one table. This was Professor Barnett. He was one of my biggest mentors, biggest influence in my life. And he really gave me the opportunity to really appreciate what it means to be a scientist, what it means to do great things and how to go about that. And so what happened next is I get a couple of emails saying, hey, we're looking for somebody with this kind of skill set for some kind of job in the United States. Packed my bags up, I moved to the United States, and I ended up here in California. It wasn't all about me, it was all about what can we do for the world. And so that's where I realized that we could do more together, working with others, to really make an impact. This is a great opportunity to start a company. And that's where we are now. We're at the headquarters of 10x Genomics, based here in Pleasanton, California. Started off with a simple napkin, writing down some ideas about how we're going to change the world. And turns out, 8 or 9 years later, that's exactly what we're doing.
I was working as a research associate after my PhD, and Chris came back to Deakin to visit during a vacation of his. I saw him in the halls and he said that 10x was looking for a synthetic chemist. I didn't know much about the company, but I knew if these guys were involved, it was an exciting opportunity. So I applied.
I was about 2 kilometres underground in a Chinese coal mine working as a gas chemist when I got a call from Chris Hindson regarding a position that opened for a synthetic chemist. And needless to say, I jumped at the opportunity to put the skills that I'd acquired during my time at Deakin to use in a much more fitting, rewarding, but challenging role.
Joined 10x, I was one of the scientific founders and had worked previously with other people and other Deaconites. Why not get more Deaconites over? And then here we are, 10x, all the way.
Prior to 10x, there was another biotech company called QuantLife, and that was also co-founded by Ben Hindson. And that's where I got my first job straight out of my PhD at Deakin University. And I worked there with Chris Hindson and Adam Lowe. And it was truly an amazing time. We got to work with such brilliant minds from a whole heap of different scientific disciplines. It was a really high risk but high reward environment, which also meant it was really work hard, play hard environment. And we were very successful at that company. We launched an instrument that's still used by the life sciences community today. And we sold the company to a large biotech company. So I kept in contact with Ben and I reached out to him and I knew he had a new startup. And I said, you know, I don't know what it is that you're doing. I don't really care. I want back in. I want a chance to go and work with my buddies from Deakin University again and do some cool science.
I was working as a postdoc at Deakin when Chris offered me the opportunity to interview at 10x, which was a company that didn't have an internet presence doing a job. They couldn't really tell me what it was going to be about. And for someone that doesn't take a lot of risk in their life, it could have been a very risky decision, but knowing that Chris and Ben were involved, it didn't seem like that much of a risk at all. And I made the decision to interview and I'm still here 7 years later and I don't regret it for a second. It's the best choice I made.
From the team, thank you, Deakin, for this award. And if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.